The opinions expressed in the following program are not necessarily those of Eastlink TV, its sponsors, or partners.
Hello, my name is Bruce Doran. I'm one of the staff scientists that works here on the third floor. And we get a lot of people that come here on the third floor asking us one particular question about turtles. Can turtles come out of their shell? And in order to answer that question, we need to better understand the biology of turtles. So this is Turtle Biology 101. So this is a Blanding's turtle. It's one of the turtles that we have here at Science North, and turtles all share similar features. If you look at the head, she's actually got a very long neck, which she used to capture food, or if she flips on her back, she can actually use her strong neck to kind of flip back on her stomach. Instead of teeth, all turtles actually have a very sharp beak, or almost beak-like lips, which they use to rip their prey apart, which is usually fish in this case. Turtles have these very strong claws, which they use to climb on surfaces, dig nests, or in the case of this turtle, will actually also rip food apart using their claws. Turtles also, you can tell the difference between male and female turtles by looking at their tail. And to tell the difference between the male and female turtle, you look for the cloaca, which is the common exit for, you know, the reproductive system, the digestive system, and the urinary system. In case of females, the cloaca is close to the edge of the shell. In the case of males, the cloaca is closer to the tip of the tail. So you can tell male and female turtles by looking at the tail. Last feature that all turtles have in common is the shell. So the upper part of the shell, we call it the carapace, whereas the lower part of the shell, we call the plastron. So let's take a closer look at the shell. So this is a replica turtle skeleton. It's actually made up of plastic, but it looks exactly like a real turtle skeleton. So what has been done is that the plastron, the belly part of the shell, has actually been removed and put in the back, so we can actually see inside the turtle shell. Now, the turtle shell is actually made up of bone, okay, the same bones as us, and the outer part of the shell is made up of keratin, the same stuff as your fingernails. Now, what's really neat is whenever a turtle grows, it will actually lose those little keratin layers that we call scutes. Now, when we look at the turtle shell a little bit closer, we notice how the backbone is actually fused to the shell. In fact, the shell is actually part of its skeleton or skeletal system. So just like us, we can't come out of our skeleton, turtles cannot come out of their shell. So the shell is actually part of their body. So whenever a turtle grows, the shell will also grow with it. Now, one interesting feature I want you guys to look at is this part. This is the forelegs, or the upper legs, and this structure here is called the scapula, or the shoulder blade. And the position of the shoulder blade is very weird in turtles compared to, say, most other animals, including humans. So this is a replica skeleton of a human. Now, this is what the skeleton will actually look like, and the shoulder blade of a human is actually found dorsally in its back. And the shoulder blade or scapula serves as attachment points for muscles so that you can actually move your arm. So in the case of humans and most other animals, it's found dorsally on the back. But in case of turtles, it's really weird. The scapula is actually found in the front. And the reason for that, the scapula can't be in the back because the shell's already there. So what's really interesting is as the turtle develops in its egg, the scapula will actually migrate towards the front, and this will allow the turtle to still be able to move its front legs and still have that protective shell layer which it needs in order to protect itself from predators. So I hope you learned a lot about turtles, and now that you can answer the question, can turtles come out of their shell? So if you want to learn more about turtles or see them, you're more than welcome to join us here at Science North.